Good morning, everyone. This is your pal Nick X1 here, and welcome back to another MCU movie review leading up to Black Widow. And today I'm doing a movie review of one of the most funniest MCU movie I have ever seen in my life. It's none other than Thor Ragnaror. Came out the year from 2017. I think Marvel Studio is one of the best year, and I think 2019 is one of the best year for Marvel, and I think 2017 is a good year for Marvel. So anyway, let's get the part started. Basically, the part is about to take place after Thor the Dark boring left off. Reason why, because that movie's so boring. And Thor doing normal stuff like always, fighting creatures and all kind of stuff. And the villain name is Hennis, so Hennis breaks Thor's hammer, and so Thor is going to fight Hulk, and so Thor and Hulk got one, and so they got to fight the villain, and that basic plot is. Sorry, basic plot one, because it's been a while I watched this movie, and I watched this movie like a couple months ago. Yeah, guys, to be honest, I haven't seen this movie in theaters, right, in the movie, because this movie came out in November, which honestly, November was a pretty okay to release a movie, because I saw a few November movies like Wreck-It Ralph 2 and especially Frozen 2. But it's the one movie, Thor Ragnarok, I really want to go see in theaters. Well, the review came along. A lot of people love this movie. And we got one YouTuber who really hates this movie. It's none other than Anthony Alpha in 2001. I really don't understand why he's getting back to hate this movie. And probably he changed his opinion on this movie. Because he wanted to finish the Josstice movie, and you know I can't stand the Josstice movie. And to be honest, this movie is way better than the Josstice movie. And this has got to be one of the most funniest MCU movie I have ever seen in my life. This movie is really a Wreck-It Ralph 2.0. Reason why? Because they have a lot of funny humor in this movie, so. So yeah, do I have any negative? Nah, I don't have any negative at all. Let's get the story. The story is really entertaining. The character still holds up, like Thor, played by Chris Hemsworth. Once again, Thor is that one of the best roles from Chris Hemsworth, and people said Chris Hemsworth and Men in Black is that one of the worst roles from him. Well, I haven't seen a movie, but I'm not watching that piece of monkey poop. And the Hulk in this movie are really likable, And Loki, and I watched that Loki series, so I'm excited for the next episodes. So yeah, Loki in this movie, Loki is so great. And my favorite character of this movie is none other than the girl. She was in Men in Black as a black woman, so I really don't know what's her name called. And you know what, I will put it in my, guys, just put a comment below, because her name is really confusing to say, because I'm a special needs and I don't know every people's name. So the villain in this movie, all fantastic. It has got to be one of the best female villain of the MCU. My best male villain from the MCU is none other than Thanos in the Avengers Infinity War and the Avengers Endgame. Well, after Black Panther, the Avengers Infinity War and Endgame is my next review, so stay tuned for that. And so the action scene looked fantastic. And the cinematography of this movie, the special effects, the CGI, all fantastic too. And the direction of it, and this is how you make a superhero movie, you stupid Josstice movie, and the stupid Josstice movie is really a perfect movie. Stupid. And the climax is an awesome climax when the Thor have his, lost his one eye. Oh my goodness, he lost his one eye. So I can see why Thor lost his one eye, because I should not watch the Avengers Infinity War, because I was saying to myself, wait a minute, what happened to Thor's eyes? Did he cut his eye off? But no, I watched this movie, his eye just cut off, just like Nick Fury and not Captain Marvel. I don't want to think about that movie, please. Garbage. And the ending was great. And I have nothing to say about this movie. I just don't want to give away a spoiler. I just give you one when Thor walks aside. So that's the only spoiler you're getting. So I don't want to spoil this funny movie. Alright, so overall, guys, Thor Ragnarok is the funniest MCU movie I have ever seen in my life. But it's a great story, great character, and great everything. And a great everything. And that walk character, I forgot what it's called. No, not the walk for actor. I'm talking about the walk. Or the walk. Played by the same guy. He was in Free Guy. And the Free Guy is going to come out pretty soon. So I'm excited for it. And I think going to even I like this movie, I'll go Going to the Galaxy Volume 2 more than this movie. Reason why? Because Going to the Galaxy Volume 2 is my favorite MCU movie of 2017. And this movie is fantastic too. I agree with the critic. I disagree with Ends Up Fantastic 1 of this movie because this movie is really hilarious. Oh my god, I laugh my butt off every time I see this movie. And there's a one cameo in the movie, like Black Widow. They took the footage from the Avengers Age of Ultron, and so they put him in this movie. So I was so edge of my seat every time I see the. I still have a crush on Black Widow. I still have a crush on her. She's sexy too for an MCU character. And so overall, guys, I'm going to give Thor Ragnarok a 10 out of 10. This is epic, brilliant masterpiece, and I cannot wait what's in store for Thor and the World of Thunder. But I'm excited for that Thor movie, and I don't understand why people's not excited for it. Oh well. Probably it's a concept, so what do you expect? So anyway, that was my movie review on Thor Ragnarok. Tell me what you thought on Thor Ragnarok. You think it's a great movie? Or just like it? Or you just like Ends Up Fantastic 1 and you don't care about this movie and think this movie's boring and think this movie's overrated? Alright, come below. Let me know. What's my next review? Alright, my next review. God damn it. Stop it right now. Alright, guys. My next movie review is Black Panther. Wakanda Forever. Wakanda Forever. If you haven't seen my movie review intro, you know what I'm talking about. Yup, stay tuned for my Black Panther review. Just for Chadwick Boseman. That's a piece of Chadwick Boseman, man. I wish he would be Black Panther. But no, 2020 would suck. And yeah, the coronavirus just got him. God damn it. Oh, no, not a coronavirus. The cancel got him. God damn it. Yeah, well, it's a piece of Chadwick Boseman. I'm just doing this review for him, so I hope you'll be happy about that. So stay tuned for my review tomorrow on Black Panther. In today's video, stay tuned for my top 10 best movie from 2019. Because I just want to redo it. Because the one video I did, the best movie from 2020 and 2019, that video did not age well. That video sunk donkey balls. And I'm just going to do a redo top 10 best movie from 2019. After that, I'm doing a lot of stinker. I'm doing top 10 worst movie from 2019. So stay tuned for that. So if you like this video, please hit the subscribe button, turn notifications, share the video with your family. And after top 10 best movie from 2019, I really don't know what my next video is going to be. So please, everyone, please request me any video you want. You want me to do a Toon Star? I will be happy to make a Toon Star. But first, I mean to try to thank a plan B for my get my Frozen 2 scene back. God damn it. Cannot believe I watched that scene because of stupid shrunk scene crap. And so, guys, I hope you have a great morning and I hope you have a great day. And after top 10 best movie from 2019, I gotta go outside and get some fresh air. And after I get done eating, we're gonna do some video together. Alright, guys, see you next time. So long. Peace, YouTube!
What would I do without you? You'll always have me.